Pharisees, the leaders of the church, they come and say, hey, look here, wait a minute. Why are you eating with who? Known sinners. The pimps and the prostitutes of the world. Those individuals who come from another society that we would rather disavow. Are you listening? Levi and Matthew chose a party, and the Bible says publicans come. Can you imagine who's at that party? Over in the corner, they might be shooting craps. Over here, they might be smoking dope. But Jesus is at the party. Not only is Jesus at the party, he's the guest of honor. And that kind of stuff can be going on at the party. Are you listening to me, church family? But Levi and Matthew is having an influence. You remember? We talked about light and salt. You guys remember light and salt? There are people who just need a little bit more light, and they'll follow Jesus. And I'm so happy about them because we're good at that as Adventists. We can give people more light. We love to give people more light, Malachi. We love to do that. You know how we, and that's a good thing. But sometimes we just love to get people from the cross to Sinai. Are you listening? Somehow we forget to get them from, get them to the cross. But we can take, we're good at taking them from the cross, Tom, and getting them to Sinai. We love the law. You understand what I'm saying? But there are people who don't have any light. They don't know anything about what we talk about. Yet, they will listen to your influence. How many of you have heard the saying, I would rather see a sermon than hear one preached any day? So I'm really excited about those who are salt hearers. The salt hearers are the people I want to talk to. You see, the salt people are the real people. Jesus knew that. Why are those people, why did Jesus always go to that side of the community? I don't know why. And I had to read the Bible to understand it. You know, I think that Jesus probably went to that side of the community because those people were real and they had real problems. And they would tell you about them. I'm a pimp. That's what I do. I'm a prostitute. That's what I do. I shoot dope. That's what I do. But you see, but when we come to church, nobody knows what we do. We put on our suits, shirts, ties, and we look good. Amen. I love looking good. Amen. Shave my head this morning. Look good for the church family. Nothing wrong with that. But when it is at the expense of telling people about Jesus, when I want to hide behind the frock that I have on, when I don't want you to know my business, oh, you didn't see, you know Jesus wants you to tell your business. Did you know that? Oh, you didn't hear me. Jesus wants you to tell your business so that you can get it out. That's why he went to sinners, because sinners wanted to get it out. They want to tell the truth. They want to stop doing what they're doing, but we don't go to them. Oh, you're not listening. The Bible says confess, listen to me now, confess your faults one with another and do what? Pray one for another that you may be what? Healed. The effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man avails much. I want you to know that God wants you to tell your business to somebody. You see, that way you can't hide anymore. Somebody, now you've got to be accountable to. Somebody, you've got to tell something about what you've been doing. You can't, I love Jesus, and keep on doing what you're doing. Amen. Salt permeates and it gets involved. It doesn't change the flavor. What does it do? It enhances. That's what we do. That's what Christians do. We get involved in people's lives. We talk about real things. We tell them what's going on in our lives. And they tell us what's going on in their lives. And the Bible says if we pray for each other, we can be healed. Come on, say amen, church. Amen. How many of you want to be healed today? You see, this is the question that I have for the church all the time, is where is our witness? Is our living in vain? Do we do this for show? Do we do this to entertain each other? Do we do this to see how many of us can keep everybody else from knowing our business? And the Bible says that my brother Levi Matthew, through this bargain, all these people came. What do we do? Is our living in that? What do we do? Turn to the book of Philippians, chapter 2. I'm going to read a few words and let you go. I want to thank you for worshiping with us today. The Bible says, if you have it, say amen.
Amen.
Philippians chapter 2, verse 1. If you have it, say amen. Amen. Not enough amen. I'll wait till you find it.
Amen.
If you have it, say amen.
Amen.
That's a few better. Amen. The Bible says, if there be now, therefore, any consolation in Christ, any comfort of love, if any fellowship of the Spirit, if any bowels and mercies, fulfill ye my joy. I love Paul. Paul gets down, doesn't he? Paul writes like he really means it. Down in my bowels. You ever talk like that? Down in my bowels. He's serious. If any bowels and mercies, fulfill ye my joy, that ye be like-minded, having the same love, being of one accord. Kim, that's a serious word. One accord. Not about you. It says, of one mind. Let nothing, now listen to me carefully. Let nothing be done through strife or vainglory. We're going to stop there. Let nothing be done to strife or vainglory. Today, number one, if our living is not going to be in vain, we can't find it from. Let nothing be done to strife or vainglory. Who gets the glory? That your light so shine that men may see your what? Good works and do what? Glorify whom? Your Father in heaven. Amen. Let them see your good works. Let people see your good works and glorify whom? The Father. How many of us love to take glory for ourselves?
Amen.
Amen. Aubrey, you did such a great job. Thank you so much, Aubrey. But if Aubrey was to stand up here and say, thank you, I've done so well, so much. Thank you for all the accolades. Thank you for touching me. Thank you for making me look good. Certainly that's not my friend, Aubrey. He has a few more humble bones than that. But if he would have stood up here and take all that glory, I dare say Jesus would have to stop you some kind of way, Aubrey. Amen. Let nothing be done through strife or vain glory. Sometimes we want credit and we didn't do anything. In fact, we never do anything because the Bible says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. So therefore, Jesus needs to get the credit for anything that I do. But most of us are always taking the credit. In this world, it's me first.
All right.